Today is the third session of Generic Elective Economics 2. In today's session, we deal with Block 3 of Generic Elective Economics 2, that is Indian Public Finance. So before getting into the core of the matter, I would like to give you a brief introduction about the topic. So the topic is that Indian Public Finance. So here the term is that public finance. When we are listening a word that is public finance, then what first comes to our mind? Public finance. So here public, it is the representative. Here public represents government. It means government is the representative of the public. So public finance means finance of the government. So here the financing of government is a matter of universal concern, practically for everyone. Now, dear learner, a question comes in mind. Why it's a matter of concern? Indian government and government of all over the world have entered and are entering into number of public projects like road making, construction of bridges, construction of hospitals, etc. It all needs amount of expenditure to be incurred, and what amount of revenue is earned from all such sources. So the expansion of public expenditure as well as the expansion of public revenue is due to the expansion in the functions of the government. So in one statement, if we are going to define that what is public finance, then it deals with the problem of adjustments of income and expenditure of the government. So to basically today's session will be on this public finance, the classification of public finance, that is the expenditure side as well as the revenue side. So today our resource person is Ms. Smuti Puja Das. She is from Odisha State Open University, and she is an academic consultant at Odisha State Open University. Now, I welcome Smuti ma'am to start the session. Smuti ma'am.
Yes, thank you so much, okay, ma'am, for the introduction. And she very clearly mentioned what is public finance and how the income and the expenditure sides of the finance are balanced. This introduction was quite required before the beginning of the session. And if you may allow, I may start the presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, what do you mean by public expenditure? To be specific in this topic, we need to understand what is public expenditure. See, whenever there is an income, there is an expenditure. In case of the government also, there is an expenditure part and there is an income part. Income of the government comes from the taxes that we pay, and the expenditure of the government is made through that. And for that reason, we need to know where and how these money goes. This is the main and basic concept behind reading the public expenditure and what are the trends that are going on towards the Indian economy and how the public expenditure is managed. माने है ना कि हमें जहाँ भी tax रुपए government को दो चु किंबा government जो तो भी आय करी ची ताको बियर कमिटी करी ची. This is the main idea why this course is introduced as a generic elective for all the disciplines. Across the discipline, everybody should know what they are paying to the government and how that money is used. Okay, so I'm starting my presentation, and then I'm sharing my screen. Rudra sir, if it is visible, please confirm me.
Okay, madam.
Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, dear learners, we will start from what are the trends in public expenditure. Okay. So, it is clearly written here what is public expenditure. Public expenditure is spending made by the government of a country on collective needs and wants such as pension, provisions of education, healthcare, and housing. Ame gote jinsa achi public goods. Public goods hela jota hospital heigala, roads heigala, dams heigala, kimba jo public transportation heigala, these are the public goods. ଏଇ ଜିନିଷ ମାନଙ୍କ ପ୍ରତି ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ କେମିତି ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ କରୁଛି, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ଦ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର୍। ଆମେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲରେ ଯାଇକି ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ କରୁନୁ, ଆମେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲ କାନ୍ଥ ତିଆରି କରୁନୁ, ଆମେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ହସ୍ପିଟାଲରେ ଡକ୍ଟର୍ସ ଆପଏଣ୍ଟ କରୁନୁ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଆୱାର ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର୍, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର୍। ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ସେମାନଙ୍କ ପାଇଁ ଟଙ୍କା ଦିଏ, ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ରେସ୍ପନ୍ସିବଲ୍ ହାଉ ଦ ଡ୍ୟାମ୍ସ ଆର୍ ୱାର୍କିଂ, ହାଉ ଦ ରୋଡ୍ସ ଆର୍ ୱାର୍କିଂ, ଇଜ୍ ଇଟ୍ ହେଲ୍ପଫୁଲ୍ ଫର୍ ଦ ପିପୁଲ୍, ଇଜ୍ ଦ ରେଲୱେ ୱାର୍କିଂ ପ୍ରପର୍ଲି, ହାଉଏଭର୍ ରେଲୱେ ହାଜ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ପ୍ରାଇଭେଟ୍ ବୋର୍ଡ, ଟ୍ରାନ୍ସପୋର୍ଟେସନ୍ ହାଜ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ପ୍ରାଇଭେଟ୍ ବୋର୍ଡ, ବଟ୍ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ବସେସ୍ ଅଛି, ଆମର OSRTC ର ବସେସ୍ ଅଛି, ଆମର ଟ୍ରେନ୍ସ ଅଛି, IRCTC ର, ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଅ ଲଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗସ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ମ୍ୟାନେଜେସ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ସେଇ ସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ପ୍ରତି କେତେ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ ହେଉଛି, କେମିତି ହେଉଛି, ୱେର୍ ଡଜ୍ ଦ ମନି କମ୍ସ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହାଉ ଡଜ୍ ଦ ମନି ଗୋଜ୍, ଏ ଜିନିଷକୁ ଆମେ ୱି ୱିଲ୍ ରିଡ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦିସ୍ ୟୁନିଟ୍, ହୁଚ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର୍, ହୁଚ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଟ୍ରେଣ୍ଡ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ପବ୍ଲିକ୍ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର୍। ଟ୍ରେଣ୍ଡ୍ସ ମାନେ ହେଲା, everyone is a 21st century student, they know what is a trend. Trend means what is going on at present, kon achi, it is a comparison of agaru kemti thila ebe kemti achi, how the country was performing, how the government was performing at the time of independence, and at present, which is 2020, how the government is presenting itself, how the money is expended, and what are the changes, and what is the change in pattern, to be precise, what is the change in pattern of the public expenditure, that is a matter of concern. Okay, then we need to know what is the public expenditure classification. Mane ama public expenditure is a broad term. Public expenditure is done for three base broad classification: revenue expenditure and capital expenditure, development expenditure and non-development expenditure, planned expenditure and non-planned expenditure. These are the classification that are meant for the public expenditure. Ame kharcha ko ei six parts re divide karu precisely, so that it becomes narrower and easily it is understood. Okay, then in this part we will not discuss about the development and non-development expenditure and planned and non-planned expenditure, since this is a part which is for the core economics paper, mane core development economics paper re development non development and planned non planned expenditure padhave. So for us it is important how the revenue and the capital expenditure works. Okay, then we will move forward and we will go to what is revenue expenditure. Okay, revenue expenditure is actually current account expenditure and is called revenue expenditure in India for historical reasons. This is mainly the current account expenditure, jota ki prati barsha hue, which occurs in a regular basis, prati masa hue kimba prati barsha hue, but due to some historical reasons it is called as the revenue expenditure. They are supposed to meet all expenditures of current nature, jota mu kohti regularly jota hue, currently jota hue, whether development or non development, whether planned or non planned. Okay, these includes what are the consistent body of this revenue expenditure: meeting the salaries of the employees, they spend on supplies of the market, this also meet the payment of interest on debts incurred by any purpose, and they also include expenditure incurred on subsidies in provisions and grants to other government and other bodies. Jo bhi kharcha lokamananko salary re hui, whatever payment is made for the salary of the people, it a prati masa hue, that is called the revenue expenditure. They also meet the payment of interest, government jaha to bhi runa nahi thai tar jo sudha dei thai, that is called the payment of interest, which happens either quarterly, monthly or on a yearly basis, it a bhi regular occurrence re hue. These include the expenditure on subsidies in provision grants to other governments and other bodies. Subsidies mane kona apan man janthe, taxes that we pay to the government, means the payment that we pay to the government is called taxes, aur jo the government amako pay karta hai, that is subsidy in terms of money, in terms of kind, mane amara gas subsidy apan sunthibe, amara jo PDS re distribution hue, public distribution system re jo kichhi bhi ase, amara gote mane negligible amount re amara wheat ase, rice ase lokamananko pakre, ଯେତେବେଳେ ଲକଡାଉନ ଇନିସିଏଟ୍ ହେଇଥିଲା ସେତେବେଳେ ଗଭର୍ଣ୍ଣମେଣ୍ଟ ଆନାଉନ୍ସ କରିଥିଲେ ଯେ 3 ମନ୍ଥସ୍ ର ରାସନ ଲୋକମାନଙ୍କୁ ଦିଆହେବ, दैट इज द सब्सिडी एंड इट कम्स इन द रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर से सरकार कहाँ टा नहीं नए दैट वॉज एन एक्सपेंडिचर मेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट एंड दैट कम्स अंडर द रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर सिंस इट इज द प्रोविजन ऑफ सब्सिडी टू द पीपल आम जिते लोक मान गवर्नमेंट टाइम दौड़ी कि कौन सी प्रकार भत्ता दौड़ी दैट कम्स अंडर द सब्सिडी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एंड दैट एंड द ग्रांट्स टू द अदर गवर्नमेंट एंड अदर बॉडीज जो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट स्टेट गवर्नमेंट मान ग्रांट्स दिए कि मैंने जो आम जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट लोकल बॉडीज मान ग्रांट दिए जो प्रकार भी हेल्प करे दैट कम्स अंडर द ब्रॉड अम्ब्रेला ऑफ रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर बट one thing which needs to be clear they do not create asset nor do they pertain to loans and advances ei kuda the revenue expenditure does not generate any kind of asset asset mane kona liability mane kona bole apan mane janthibe asset hochi jo thre amaku kichi income hue liability hochi jo thre amaku payment kariba ko pade asset of the government does not include the salary of the employee the supply the subsidy or the interest payment mane hala je government ko sethro kichi labha hue nahi salary of the employee does not come directly as cash to the people to the government mane je government ethu kichi labha pau nahi in terms of money not in terms of services that is a different altogether a different concept so this is clear that revenue expenditure does not create any kind of asset and they do not pertain to loans and advances okay then we will move to what is capital expenditure capital expenditure on the other hand is the expenditure incurred to certain assets physical or financial here comes the twist why what is the difference between a capital expenditure and a revenue expenditure sethi bhi government payment karchi ethi bhi government payment karchi but here assets are created what are the assets they may be physical or financial sethi amara kichi asset which is neither physical nor financial these were not created in case of the revenue expenditure expenditure incurred on construction of buildings layings of railway lines or making roads buildings dams or hydroelectric power station etc or acquiring physical property is called capital expenditure capital expenditure mane kon hala construction of buildings laying of railway lines nua nua jagah re railway ko communication pahunche ba construction of new buildings apan manko college building he gala kimba jo office buildings he gala these are funded by the government and they do create utility out of them either through physicality or financiality see ame jete bale revenue expenditure koruchi ame sete bale government ra pakhare there is no physical or financial asset to show ki mu yanku tanka deli I got this I received this but in case of capital expenditure the government either has a physical object to show or a financial statement to make either through construction of dams or hydroelectricity power station or the roads that they make or the railway lines they put on or by acquiring capital expenditure these are the benefits that the government gets they are now able to show where they have expended this much of money giving loans and advances create financial asset for the government on which they may earn interest same jitte bale loan diyanti either to the state or to a private organization or to some other country it becomes their asset because they will earn interest out of it mane government jodi kahaku loan kimba advance douchi se manko se sudha adaya karibo that is a financial asset these are the list of physical asset jota physically producible this is the financial asset which is the loan and advances that they create after meeting the capital expenditure and the interest received in turn are revenue received revenue received bolki taku kuha jae see there are two concept in economics what hela cost and what hela revenue आमे जोटा पे करू दैट इज द कॉस्ट व्हाट वी रिसीव इज कॉल्ड द रेवेन्यू तो सेटा को कहै छै कि द एंड इंटरेस्ट रिसीव्ड इन टर्न इज कॉल्ड द रेवेन्यू रिसीव्ड दिस हैज नथिंग टू डू विद रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर एज सच दिस इज अ वेरी क्लियर कांसेप्ट रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर रे कोन हला देयर वाज नो फिजिकल और फाइनेंशियल एसेट क्रिएटेड But in case of the capital expenditure, there was either a physical asset or a financial asset that was created by the government by incurring this expenditure. Okay, then we will move forward. Before this, what are the trends in the capital and the revenue expenditure that we have seen in last a few decades? In a few decades. The first major trend in public expenditure which we observed in India is growing revenue expenditure of the government, and it has increased from 8,358 crores in 1980-81 to 156,605 crores in 2010-11. This is a precise expenditure of the revenue side. Revenue expenditure means what? As we have discussed, expenditure meant for the subsidy, the increase in the payment to of the salary or in the pension provision, which does not create any kind of financial assets. Then, the capital expenditure during the same period has increased 20 times, which is from 8,358 crores to It has increased from 8,358 crores to 156,605 crores in 2010-11. This is the capital expenditure. The revenue expenditure has increased from 14,000 crores to 10,40,723 crores, which is 80 times more. And they do not perform or create any kind of physical or financial asset. Rather, the capital expenditure which increases the asset of the government is 20 times increase in last means 1980 to 2010-11, which is almost 30 years. In 30 years, capital expenditure increased 20 times, whereas the revenue expenditure has increased 80 times. So you can see the difference what is created and as you are all intelligent enough, you can figure out what is the loophole in this country. And why do we need to read this public expenditure? Because this public expenditure is a process through which we measure inflation of a country, through which we measure the growth of a nation. So you can see the growth of a nation when revenue income has increased 80 times and capital expenditure has increased 20 times. Okay, then we will move forward and we will discuss about what is budget. Okay, you all are quite familiar with this word, what is budget. Budget has come from a word that is bagwit, and Indian cinema has influenced you all that much that you know what is bagwit. It is a bag. But what does budget means is a financial statement of a country, and financial statement of a country which deals with the expenditure and income of a country in a particular point of time. See, why am I saying this for a particular point of time? That in one year, in every year, there is a union budget that is presented in our country. And in that union budget, it is determined that how much income will a country get and how much expenditure it is planning to make. This is the concept of budget that we have seen. The first budget of independent India was presented by R.K. Sanmukham Shetty on November 26, 1947. This was the date when, after independence, we produced our first union budget. But in 1850, the first budget was presented, and that was not an independent India. So this is what we consider as the first budget of our country. Okay, Then the union budget is a comprehensive display of government finances. It is most widespread account of the government's finances, which includes revenue from all sources and expenses of all activities undertaken, are aggregated. It is prepared and presented annually. This is what I was telling you. See, it is an account that deals with the revenue that we get from all the sources, that we will earn from all the sources, and then the expenses of the activities that are undertaken and are aggregated. We, from the initial of the financial year, decide that what would be the expenditures that we are going to make in this year and where from the money will come so as to meet the expenditure. Okay. If this much is clear, then I will move forward. Am I audible? Is it clear? Any student? Okay, then we will move forward and we will get to know what are the various constituents of the budget, how the budget is presented. Okay, see, there is a classification of the revenue budget and the classification of the capital budget that we have seen in this, that we are going to see in this chapter. See, these are very clearly and well defined in your SLM materials. You can see this from the SLM materials, what is revenue budget, what is capital budget, and there is clear definition to all of these in the SLM. Revenue budget consists of the revenue received and the revenue expenditure that I was telling. See, you have to see what is a revenue receipt and what is the revenue. And what is the revenue expended? See, revenue received, how do you earn from the revenue? It is called the tax revenue and the non-tax revenue. Government earns from taxes. This is known to all of you, that how the government earns money. Government koti ki means kam kariwa pai jaye nahi, but it earns. Earn correct, sahi pai the expenditure correct. So what are the revenue, what, how from the where from the government gets money to spend? That is the main concern of the topic. And what is the revenue received? Revenue received is the tax revenue and the non-tax revenue. Okay, that includes taxes from that are direct taxes and there are indirect taxes. Okay, revenue expenditure already we have discussed. Okay, this is what we get from the revenue budget. We get revenue received and the revenue expended. This we earn from tax revenue and non-tax revenue. This tax revenue consists of direct taxes and indirect taxes. There is also capital budget, which is capital received and capital expenditure. That includes the asset, the liability concept. That is why we will not discuss it here because it is beyond our purview. But for idea, we must know how the classification of the government budget is done. Okay. So, what are the tax revenue and non-tax revenue? Then we will move forward and we will see to it what is direct taxes and what are indirect taxes. See, the union budget is an account of government finances in which revenues of all sources and activities of all expenses of all activities are undertaken and are aggregated. Okay, this is the sum total of basically the sum total of all the expenses and all the revenue that are received by the government. The Government of India budget is primarily made up of revenue budget and the capital budget that we have discussed. That is, this is the explanation to the diagram. The revenue of the Union Government of India has been further classified into tax and non-tax revenue. The tax revenue consists of direct and indirect taxes. See, now what I am saying, what is tax? See, tax is the compulsory payment that an individual makes to the government without a quid pro quo. What is quid pro quo between a taxpayer and the public authorities? See, if I am paying taxes, I cannot force the government that do this, do that. It is the government which shows me through the budget that how my tax is going to be used. I am not supposed to get a direct result or a direct influence by the tax that I pay. See, we stay in Odisha. If road construction is done at Maharashtra, are we going to be directly affected by that? No, in no way. But we cannot say that don't take our taxes to Maharashtra. We cannot say that. That is what is called the quid pro quo between a taxpayer and the public authorities. You cannot claim that my money should be used as direct benefit to me. Okay, that is what is called the quid pro quo between a taxpayer and the public authorities. Okay, direct taxes are imposed on income and wealth of the individual or the organization. Okay, see. Direct taxes is the tax that directly an individual or an organization pays to the government. Okay, directly. It includes the taxes that we pay for the municipality services, that we pay directly to the government, that we pay for the use of the public goods, that are direct taxes. Or if the individual pays income tax, it is a direct tax. When the organization pays for the means the production process, that is a direct tax, that is a direct tax to the government. The burden of the direct tax cannot be distributed to any other person. See, if I am paying an income tax amount, that I cannot shift to anybody else. Means the impact and the incidence of this tax falls directly upon the individual. Impact and incidence means what? See, when we will come to indirect tax, we will discuss it. Direct taxes are progressive in nature and the rate of tax rises along with tax base, which are instrumental in reducing income inequalities. This is a very clear concept. Apartment language, jete besi income thai loka manankara, sete besi tax they have to pay. মানে জনে যদি 25,000 পে ইনকাম আছে তার দে আর এক্সেম্পটেড ফেন দ্য ইনকাম গ্রাজুয়ালি ইনক্রিজেস দ্য পার্সেন্টেজ অফ ট্যাক্স উইচ ইজ কল্ড দ্য ট্যাক্স স্ল্যাব দ্যাট ইনক্রিজেস ট্যাক্স বেস মিনস ওয়ার বিলো দ্যাট বেস পিপল আর এক্সেম্পটেড ফ্রম দ্য পেমেন্ট অফ ট্যাক্স ওকে সি হোয়াট আই ওয়াজ সেইং ইনডাইরেক্ট ট্যাক্সেস আর ইম্পোজড অন কমোডিটিজ অ্যান্ড কম্প্রাইজেস অফ সেল ট্যাক্স সার্ভিস ট্যাক্স এক্সাইজ ডিউটি custom duty, VAT, etc. The impact and incidence of indirect taxes falls on different entities. See, impact means what? Government has imposed a tax on Hindustan Unilever. Hindustan Unilever agaru jitebele taro 1 lakh crore turnover thila, that was paying 10% of tax. Ebe government kahila na, there is a influence of the pandemic, you have to pay 12% of your income. Immaterial stake of your increase or decrease in income, you have to pay 12% of tax. Jadi Hindustan Unilever 90,000 crore turnover hai jauchi, tahle bhi taku 12% tax karibaku padibo. For that reason, for that matter, what will Hindustan Unilever do? Se jo commodities produce korchi, তার প্রাইস কু ইনক্রিজ করদব যদি সে প্রাইস গুলা ইনক্রিজ হয়ে যাব দেন দ্য ইনসিডেন্স মিন্স হোয়াট দ্য কনজিউমার হু আর পারচেজিং লাভ সে ওয়ালা পন সে ওয়ালা দিজ আর ডেইলি গুডস দে দিজ আর মেটেরিয়ালস দ্যাট আর ফাউন্ড ইন অলমোস্ট অল দ্য হাউস হোল্ড লোক মানে সে ট্যাক্স কু পে করবে ইম্প্যাক্ট ফেল অপন হিন্দুস্তান ইউনিলিভার এন্ড দ্য ইম্প্যাক্ট হ্যাপেন অপন ইউর পকেট. This is what is called indirect tax system. But this is not same in case of the direct tax. Mane, jaha upar impact, tara upar incidence. Directly, Hindustan Unilever has to pay some amount of money to the government that they cannot shift or they cannot give to the consumer. Semane lokamananku dei paribe nahi, je lokamane pay karibe ya pai. Okay, this indirect taxes include sales tax, service tax, excise duty, custom duty, VAT, etc. And this is the main reason why the increase in the prices of the commodity increases. Eita hela main reason jodi paiki amara jo prices ame jo goods or commodities ra prices increase hela bole seithi paiko taxes increase heibo you have to pay a more amount to the government so as to ensure that you stay in the business. If you don't pay to the government, then the government will take the necessary action. You cannot deny the payment of taxes to the government, and these are uniform. Samasta ka pani a taxes same hai. Okay, then there are they have a lot of examples of indirect taxes that we can give. See, those students who are a technical means technically attracted, as we all know, the prices of mobile phones has increased these days. Why has that increased? Because the import export has changed, and the prices, the taxes that were imposed on the excise duties that were imposed has increased, which is the reason why you have to pay more for the same mobile phone now, which you were paying before a month or a week ago, before 2 or 3 months ago, before the lockdown happened. Okay, these are the various causes, but why there is indirect taxes and what are the impact and incidence. Okay, then we will move further. Indirect taxes are regressive in nature. See, there are progressive, regressive. These two terms, I'm not getting into it. These are typical economics terms, and they have a different. I can take another class for that. Okay, that is why I'm not exaggerating it. In nature, since the burden of taxes is eventually transferred to the consumer who pay the same amount of tax regardless of their income level. आपणंकर इनकम 5000 हो किंवा 10000 हो कि 1 करोड हो, इफ यू आर यूजिंग अ लक्स, इफ द लक्स प्राइस इज 10 रुपीज फॉर द इनकम ऑफ 5000, फॉर 25000 एंड फॉर 1 करोड दिस रिमेन्स द सेम. इफ द प्राइस ऑफ लक्स हैज इंक्रीज टू 15 रुपीज, इट इज सेम. इट इज 15 फॉर द 5000 इनकम ग्रुप, इट इज सेम 15 रुपीज फॉर द 25000 ग्रुप, एंड इट इज 15 रुपीज फॉर 1 करोड ग्रुप. It means what? Indirect taxes falls on people irrespective and regardless of the income level that they belong to. Okay, the incidence falls on people regardless of their income level. Okay, non-tax revenue include all the revenue other than taxes accruing to the government. These are internally generated funds. Okay, what are non-tax revenue and how these internally generated funds are created? See, internally generated funds means there are certain ministries that funds the government. There are certain funds that the ministries are providing to the government. There are revenues that the other ministries are providing, like that of the Ministry of I'm forgetting the name. Okay, fine. There are certain ministries that pay to the non-tax revenue of the government, and that are internally generated fund. We are not talking about the funds that come from outside the country, and here we have not discussed anything about that comes from outside the country. Okay, these are internally generated fund. There are certain state revenue. See, there are certain state revenue, certain amount of money that the state government also has to pay to the central government, that are non-tax revenue, and that are included as internally generated funds to the state government. Okay, see, these are the tax revenues. These are the direct taxes, the income tax, the capital gain tax, the security tax, the prerequisite tax, corporate tax. These are the various taxes that are coming under the direct taxes, and direct taxes do not are those which have impact incidence on the same person. Mane jahara upre impact thibo sei tax ro se hi pay koriba taku. It cannot be shifted to somebody else. Okay, capital gain tax, security transaction tax, prerequisite tax, corporate tax. There are certain corporate taxes also that corporate houses have to pay directly to the government. Okay, there are certain indirect taxes also that are called the sales tax, the service tax, the custom duties, and custom duties on goods and services. These are the duties that are paid for export and import. Okay, excise duties and the other duties are also, the value added taxes are also included in it. Okay, so These are the various types of taxes that are paid to the government through directly or through indirectly. Indirect taxes, I have already told you, their impact and incidence falls on people, means two different people. And if the incidence falls on you, then you have to pay to the you have to pay regardless of your income category. Okay, next. These are the non-tax revenue that I was discussing. Non-tax revenue includes all revenue other than taxes accruing to the government. These are internally generated funds that are interest receipts, dividends and profit from public enterprises. These are profit received from public enterprises. They are not private enterprises. There are certain companies, means there are certain enterprises that are owned by the government. Okay. And the fees, the fines and penalty, the fines and penalty that you pay for the for being a defaulter in wearing a mask or a helmet, that is considered as a non-tax revenue. Taro kichi limit nahi. Okay. Special assessment of betterment levy. Okay, then grants and gifts. The grants and gifts that the government receives is called non-tax revenue. These are the funds generated internally through institutions like certain ministries, various government departments like CPWD. Okay, then various government agencies. Okay, these are the various ways how the government generates funds. Apart from that of the taxes that we pay, and that is used as the revenue, that is used as the expenditure later on. Okay. See, since that is the part that is inside our book, mani sei sabu jinso is in our book. This is something, this is not in the book. Okay. Eta hela the current tax structure of India. It has a proposed tax structure. This is the image that has been taken from the internet. And this is not the proposed tax structure. This is the current tax structure of the country. Ame purvaru direct taxes, indirect taxes, we were discussing these two things. Ebe kono, direct tax only includes income tax. Indirect taxes have now become GST, except custom duties that are outside India. Those things are that are outside India, that are a different concept. Okay, GST mane kona apan mane samasya jantu, that is a goods and service tax, and that has been introduced in 2017. That has changed, that has a different role to play altogether. The previous system that I would show, these are direct indirect taxes, the tax means, and the structure is quite a confusing thing. Money, direct taxes, income tax, corporate tax, the gifts and grants, there are various things that came under that. But due to the arrival of GST, it has been simplified. And this GST has a different role in different states. This is the intra-state GST, means two different states. Intra-state GST is in the state. Interstate GST is GST for two different states. See, intrastates include CGST, SGST. CGST is Central Goods and Services Tax. Within your own state, ame Odisha bhitare central GST bhi mano, state GST bhi mano. There are two different type of GST that comes under the intrastate GST. But in case of interstate GST, what happens? Tita state, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, West Bengal, Kimba, Odisha, Bihar, Kobi state, ho, that accept central GST, which is the IGST. Okay, interstate happens, and there is only a single system of GST that comes into prevalence. Okay, so this is a tax structure that has been changed, and now a new system has arrived, that is the goods and services tax. Is an indirect tax or consumption tax used in India on supply of goods and services. It is a comprehensive, multi-stage, destination-based tax. It is quite a comprehensive and multi-stage tax. Why it is multi-stage? This has different stages. interstate, intrastate, CGST, SGST, IGST. Okay, but all of them are GST. They do not have different names. They do not have octroi tax. They do not have sales tax, these services tax. All these are comprised of the GST now. Okay, comprehensive because it has summed almost all the indirect taxes except a few state tax. That's what we're discussing, that only certain few state tax are there, except that all other indirect taxes comes under GST in these days. Multi-stage, as it is, the GST is imposed at every step in production process. Yes, in every production process, this GST is put. You have to pay for the final product as well as in the production process. But is meant to be refunded to all parties in various stages of production in other than the final consumer and as a destination-based tax. Set a return waiver at different level and different destination-based. Okay, but only when it comes to the final consumer, it is not returned. Production processing, that could return be corrupted. It is collected from point of consumption and not from the point of origin, like previous taxes. Point of consumption re a payment corrupted, not at the point of origin. Mane, originally, amar kono taxes thila, direct taxes and indirect taxes, they were like income taxes. Income asila. Mane, you have to pay taxes. Corporate taxes were taxes that are paid even before the production process has started. But right now, because of the GST, in the consumption process, you have to pay, not from the initials of the production process. If this is clear, then we will move forward. Is it clear? Hello? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. We have covered all the topics.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead. Students are writing that it's clear. Up to this, they are clear.
Okay, this is the completion of all the topics that we had for the two units that was assigned to me.
Okay.
If they have any questions, then we can move forward.
Okay. So dear learners, if you have any query or any doubt regarding the topic that are covered now, so you can ask in the chat box. So if any kind of query, then please ask through writing a question so that ma'am will clear your doubts. Rakesh, if you have any doubt, then please ask to ma'am. She will clear your doubt.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, then we proceed.
Yeah, sure.
Today's session was nice, and ma'am has completed the total syllabus that is assigned to her, and she, in a simpler way, she defined everything starting from the topic public finance to its classification, that is revenue, and that is expenditure side as well as the revenue side. So expenditure side, revenue expenditure, capital expenditure, all the things were cleared in a simpler way, and I think it is all clear to the learners. She also cleared what is budget. That budget defines nothing but the financial statement which constitutes all the sources of revenue and expenditure that plan to incur. Then again, she defined or give a very clear picture of classification of budget, that is revenue budget, capital budget, then again the segregation of revenue budget in terms of revenue receipt and revenue expenditure, then again the classification of revenue received in terms of tax revenue, non-tax revenue, then again the taxes are divided into direct taxes and non-direct and non-tax revenues and indirect taxes. So all the things they are very clearly taught by ma'am, and she also gives the clear picture of tax structure in India, means the number of taxes or the taxes that are prevalent in India currently. So in this way I hope that today's session is very much beneficial, and it is it will benefit them for their future also, because all these topics not only relevant in study, but it is very much beneficial in our day-to-day life. We must know that what is budget and how it is influencing common man's life. So in this way today's session is very much important, and it is nicely conducted. So for this I thank to our resource person Smuti ma'am. Thank you ma'am for such a wonderful presentation and making our student clear about the Indian public finance. Then I would also like to thank the technical support and all the learners who plays a major role. So once again, thank you to all.
Ma'am, if we can
thank you, ma'am.
Provide them with the details of the next class, then it will be more beneficial, I think.
Okay. I would like to clear one more thing, that this is today whatever taught to you is the block 3, means the block 3 constituted 5 units. The first two units will be covered in was covered in today's session, and in the next session, that I think that would be conducted on Friday 3:30 p.m. 3:30 to 5 p.m. on that day a resource person will cover the rest of the topics, all the rest 3 units in block 3. So it would be a request to the learners then that they must again join that session also, so that the block 3 will be completed, because this is one part of block 3. The next part will be covered on that session, and that will taken by Dr. Ashish Das from Odisha State Open University, the resource person. So it's a request to the learners, so without any fail, without delaying or without any fail, they must join the next session also, because that will be the next part of this block 3, Indian public finance. This is the first introductory part, that trends in public expenditure and the budget. Then the rest 3 units will be covered in the next session on Friday. So with this, if any query from learner side regarding the next session?
No ma'am.
Okay, so no. अच्छा तुम मैंने जी जी भी आज क्लास मुझे को रिक्वेस्ट करुच्ची कि जो मैंने आसी ना कि जान पारी ना जदि आपण मैंने भी टी इंटीमेट करदे कि कम्युनिकेट करदे भी इट वुड बी मोर बेनिफिशियल बिकज एमती भी बहुत जन अच्छा जो मैंने आईदर लिंक पाई नए कि जान पार नए फेल हो जाए तो बोल कि आप कंटाक्ट जो जो मैंने अच्छा जेनरिक इलेक्टिव इकोनॉमिक्स टू रे आप कंटाक्ट कर दिंतु कि यहाँ फर्स्ट पार्ट तो ओवर है तार रेकर्डिंग से शुपारे द नेक्स्ट सेशन विल बी कंडक्टेड ऑन फ्राइडे इवनिंग इन द पोस्ट लंच सेशन दैट इज एट 3:30 p.m. टू 5 p.m. ओके okay, I think it is clear. Okay, so thank you ma'am once again, and thank you to all the technical support team and to our learners also. So I think we should stop the session.
Thank you ma'am.
Okay,
thank you so much sir. Thank you so
yes,
much
madam.
Sir.
thank you
okay.